Well, what do we have here? Do I hear an unattended picnic basket? Hey, boo-boo, me and you just got a luncheon or two. Who is this? Pay no attention to us bears. If you don't tell the park rangers, I can even share with you this lovely apple tart there. You want some information on bears? Woo-hoo-hoo, have you come to the right guy? I'm smarter than your average bear and not shy.
Welcome back to a Compendium of Monsters. This week's entry, bears. Before we continue, please make sure you've subscribed to this channel. It helps me out a lot. Black bears are challenge level 1/2, large-sized beasts. They have an armor class of 11, average hit points of 19, a speed of 40 feet, and a climbing speed of 30 feet. Black bears, as well as bears in this video, have the keen smell trait, giving them advantage on perception checks related to smells. Black bears have a basic multi-attack that allows them one attack with their bite and one attack with their claws.
Hey boo-boo, it's me and you. Brown bears are challenger level 1, large-sized beasts. Hey, who are you calling a beast? You're gonna get more than you bargained for. We got 11 armor. Hey boo-boo. What does that do? 34 hit points, a speed of 40 feet, and a climbing speed of 30 feet. It says we climb trees. Hey, boo-boo, we gotta get some traps in those trees and get those picnic baskets. If you get me and boo-boo angry, we got two attacks.
Cave bears and polar bears are challenge level 2, large-sized beasts. They have an armor class of 12, average hit points of 42, a speed of 40 feet, and a swim speed of 30 feet. Cave bears, not polar bears, have dark vision out to 60 feet. Cave and polar bears have a basic multi-attack, though it hurts much more than the first two bears. Polar bears also come in the huge variety, though all this does is increase their average health to 65. If you want to throw your players through a loop, you could throw an awakened brown bear or a skeletal polar bear at them. Both bears are statistically similar to their normal counterparts, though the skeletal polar bear picks up the vulnerabilities and immunities of being undead. Specifically, vulnerable to bludgeoning damage while being immune to poison damage, the poison condition, and the exhausted condition. The awakened brown bear, however, gains the ability to speak one language spoken by their creator. I have some major issues with one of the environments that Wizards has suggested for polar bears. The Underdark. First off, polar bears spend a lot of time fishing. Polar bears are hypercarnivorous, meaning 70% or more of their diet consists of meat. Other than the Dark Lake, there isn't a large body of water for polar bears to consistently get food, and the food they would obtain wouldn't be high in blubbery fat like those delicious little seals they like to eat. Yes, polar bears could hypothetically stalk the tunnels of the Underdark in search of food, but there's a slight problem. It's basically always dark in the Underdark. Polar bears don't have dark vision. Why? Why would you do this, Wizards? Do you even read the material you put out? Polar bears have been naturally selected for survival on icy terrain. If you plunk them in the Underdark, they might survive, but they mostly will probably die. Instead of putting polar bears in the Underdark, substitute cave bears. At least cave bears might survive 10 minutes in that horror-infested land.
Look at that chunky floof.
But it's danger floof, so no pets. Black bears exist primarily in Canada,
eh?
After a plethora of extirpations in the United States. Black bears have an omnivorous diet and spend most of their time in heavily forested areas. However, if they find food more readily available in human communities, don't be surprised if they come knocking. Interestingly, black bears get 85% of their food from vegetation, so you might not get eaten if you encounter one. However, black bears can absolutely climb trees and swim, so you might want to find an alternative escape route if you're going camping in the Great White North. Granted, black bears are lazy and won't pursue food options that are too difficult, so they'll probably get their protein from catching salmon spawning in a river.
The finale is up to me and you, boo-boo. We brown bears are found in Canada and across the North part of Eurasia? Hey boo-boo, where is Eurasia? Brown bears eat all the food we can reach, but I'd prefer to get your picnic basket. If there are no picnic baskets, we might dig up some root veggies or catch some fish. And by catch fish, I mean surprise a fisherman making a delicious fish dish. We love to eat fruit, though brown bears in Yellowstone eat upwards of 40,000 army cutworm moths a day. Say boo-boo, what are these cutworm moths anyway? If a brown bear finds himself at the coast, they would be smart to dig up some clams and make a chowder. Though the best part of being a brown bear is everyone is frightened of you. If I smell a delicious kill and someone else did the work, I'll butt in for some free food. What are they going to say? Heckin' go away? I am 400 pounds if you can't boss me around.
What do you all think about bears? Have you ever had a bear as a pet in Dungeons & Dragons? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that subscribe button, smash that like button, and share my video on your Twitter, Facebook, or other social media. I'll see you all next time.